Hey guys, I realized that I said I was going to talk about Rachel Griffin, who is a fabulous artist, and if you want to look her up, go to Rachel Griffin Music on her YouTube. And I may do her in a future episode, but due to my friend's birthday coming up at the end of this month, my tattoo has the wrong date, but I don't know if I can show it up here, but it's one day off, and I think it's the 25th, I could be wrong, it's just the 26th, I think. Anyway, Claudia Hope is and was a great person. Why do I say is and was? Well, to put it simply, he touched everybody's life. And everybody loved him. You know, he was a fabulous person. You've seen my videos on YouTube. And I'm gonna make this short so I can put a song at the end of this. But I just wanted to do this episode about Cody because he was a great friend to many people. Cody was actually a helper of mine for a number of years before he went off to college. And I'll never forget the day that it happened. I've probably done a video about this before. If I have, watch it again. Cody was had a very good sense of humor. Everybody loved him. If you go to my channel, there are several Cody Hope tribute videos. And you'll see why. Cody was loved by everybody. His funeral procession was, I believe, 5 miles long, that it said in the reports, said in the papers. And when Cody passed away, I was asked to do interviews, which I didn't mind doing, but at the same time, because I know that's what Cody would want me to do, but at the same time, it was, for me, doing the interviews, having people come to my house, having the news come to my house the day of Cody's funeral, that was a difficult thing to do. You know, and the reporter asked me, how is it that you're so upbeat? How is it that you're so not crying, not so down? And to put it simply, Cody wouldn't want me to be that way. With his birthday coming up in a couple weeks, I've been down, moody, and a little bit angry or abrasive or whatever you want to call it. But a friend of mine came over today Well, by the time anybody watches this, it'll be... my friend came over on the 14th of June. And we played, he brought his guitar, and we just had a good time. We played Christian songs. But the thing I realized is that, yes, I'm upset that Cody's still not here. But the thing is, you gotta live life the best way you can. And that's exactly what Cody did. You know, he did the best with what he had. His dream was to be a professional baseball player. And the ironic thing was, on the opening game of the season of the 2007, they were on their way down to Florida to open up the game for Bluffton University. Open up the gaming season for Bluffton University, and they didn't make it there. But see, the ironic thing is, even with him being a freshman, they were going to let him pitch in that game. That's how good of a baseball player he was. If you look at Cody E. Hope on Google, you'll find his obituary. Yes, you'll find my name in it. Like I said, I considered him a brother. He was a very dear friend of mine. And he still is. And today I realized that Cody wouldn't want me to be down. Cody wouldn't want me to be upset. Cody wouldn't want me to be angry. But neither does God. Neither does Jesus Christ. I've never come out and blatantly said, you know, this. But I now understand that I can't be that way. You know, when I was singing with my friend today, when we were worshiping, I enjoyed it. It brought me back to a fullness, to being happy. Every time I talk about Cody, I get down. Because you see, he died at 19 years old. He was about to be 20. And that was the year he was going to be 20 years old. He died March 2nd, 2007, among 7 or 8 other people. And I feel bad for those families. The thing is that I can't tell Cody's story. The best way I can show you is by putting a link to the second edition video I did that has 2 extra pictures. I would like you to watch that. If you're watching this on iTunes, the link is, my YouTube link is the website that's listed. If you're watching this on YouTube, search search in my channel, go to Cody Tribute video, second edition, and that's the video I'm referring to. For YouTube users, I'm going to put the video in the description bar. And in closing, because I want to play that song, in closing, just realize what you've got. You got a life. Granted, your life may not be as perfect, may not be as grand, may not be what you want it to be. But ask God, and He'll give you the right answers. He'll give you what you need to survive. You know, I think about Cody, and I think back to his personality. And he wouldn't want me to be down and depressed and blah, blah, blah. He would want me to be bubbly. But today, I'm a mixture of everything. Towards the end of the day, I get tired. But I just want you to think. And I hope everyone has a good week, weekend, I should say. And happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. If I don't get to play the full song, I'm sorry. But I hope everyone has a good day. God bless, and look out for the next episode. Thanks. When winter falls, next year I'll be holding on to anything nailed down. As for being patient with fate and all, it's getting old, and my mind is slowly changing. I'm calling all my oldest friends, saying sorry for this mess we're in, and I'm waiting, waiting for the sun to come and melt this snow, wash away the pain and give me back control. An angel got his wings and we'll hold our heads up knowing that he's fine. We'd all be lucky to have a love like that in a lifetime. Should we still set his play? Should we still save his chair? Should we still buy him gifts? And if we don't, did we not care? It makes you think about the life you've led, the shit you've done, the things you've said, and it's grounding, grounding. I've been feeling 3 feet tall this month, hardly indestructible, but the snow melts and the rhythm still goes on. An angel got his wings and we'll hold our heads up knowing that he's fine. We'd all be lucky to have a love like that in a lifetime. Stay side by side in life and death. You've always stole my heart.